I'm not a wannabe or a frustrated author. I'm sitting here telling you all these things. I'm not. I am a lover of the arts and the written word and you guys. I love to support you behind the scenes. I do love that ever elusive, well-crafted sentence and coffee. I do know and follow the trends. The first thing I do every workday is check out the trade. What's signing? What's happening to the bookstores? What's going on in the digital market? What's happening internationally? And people have called me a friend broker. In some ways, I laugh at the amount of my skill set is connecting people and kind of getting my foot in every door. I can rattle all these things up, but I'm not. But whether it's in the general market, whether it's in the faith-based market, whether it's in film or television, digital extracurricular rights issues, I really try to follow those and have my fingers in most of those. We'll go on the one extreme. You've got these guys, I'll just say guys, guys and gals that are real wordsmiths. They may be the former authors, they may be writers themselves, they may have worked at a publishing house. They'll dig into the conjugation of verb on page 173. They will, and they're great at that. Then you have the other extreme, and it's these guys that may be attorneys or former sales guys, and they just want a widget. They'll throw it against the wall, throw the sticks. And if it doesn't, next, what else you got? And they should have a great Rolodex of money. Personally, I'm somewhere in the middle. And it depends on the client. Some clients, I get much more deeply involved. Whoever picked up the Amy Gaker book, that one, we literally worked on that together, chapter by chapter. She'd send me a chapter every 6 weeks. So I was very involved. Some of these other books, I don't even know. Some of these others, I haven't been involved because they're so... They got it made. They basically just say, hey, I've got a contract for you to negotiate, and I don't want to do it, essentially. So an agent themselves can... they can run the gamut, and your relationship with that agent will depend on what you're looking for and what your needs are on that pendulum. If I'm your agent, you want me talking about you 20 times a month and not talking to you 20 times a month. I've had a couple through the years that have said, hey, you didn't comment on my post on Facebook or something. Do you want me doing that? Do you want me spending my time doing that instead of being on the phone with you? Get that. Agent doesn't necessarily... Shouldn't be expected to brainstorm for book ideas every Friday at 8:30, unless your name is Nicholas Sparks or James Patterson or Max McCaleb. A couple things you may want to know. Not every agent reads every word that every client writes. And I know you it's your baby. I get that. I worked in the music industry before as a manager. By very definition, an agent, like I was talking about the guy, he brings deals. By very definition, the agent says, hey, I got a deal for you, you want it? Great. Doesn't really care about the implication of the bigger picture. A manager, theoretically, is that hub with all the spokes right now. So he's looking at every part of their career. So it's music, it's touring, it's recording, it's writing, it's digital, it's television, it's accounting, whatever. He looks at all. Because that was my background on music management, I agent with a manager hat on.